of Canada. She recently suffered a foot injury that kept them out of the Canadian National Championships, and Donna DeVerona talked with her about it.
Barbara, you were injured. Are you completely recovered?
Yes, I'm fine now. It took a while. We were off for about 3 weeks and then came back very, very slowly. But I think that was good because we really didn't want to jeopardize ourselves for the Olympics.
When you get injured, people, as a single athlete, you have to deal with it on a physical level. But I would think when you're part of a
it's
team...
It's harder in a team. Because it's not just yourself that's injured, it's also your partner. When you're injured, you've got somebody else to worry about, and it's hard.
How long did it take you to recover from her injury?
It took a while. I mean, I can still go into the rink and skate every day, and you know that she wasn't going to come in, and you just had to go out there and free skate and push yourself through the solo sections of the program and that. But it almost makes you want to work harder because you realize that the person coming back is going to be a little bit down in conditioning and isn't going to have the confidence they had prior. So you have to be that much better to support them through those, you know, the coming back stage. So it's a little bit of a blessing in disguise, so to speak, because you have to work harder and you're in better condition to help the other person come back.
Barbara Underhill and Paul Martini from Canada.
Now, this is a wonderful young pair. They're very good looking. They've got great speed and great energy, and they have a shot at any one of the medals in this competition. Stretch your leg. First one, lasso overhead. Good leg to zip pick up there.
I'm going to say, Dick, the general consensus is they would finish third, but of course, with what happened to Bass and Shear back earlier, maybe the expectations will be higher now.
No one knows. So beautifully at that point too. Now that's a complete failure on their part to do that whole move. So the here comes the back inside Desbarro, but really, you know, I mean, you know, that's the name of the game right there. That the door is open now for Kitty and Peter. Just leave it closed. They're going to skate their best. Let's not put the pressure on them.
You don't want to say anything, I know.
I don't want to say a thing.
It's obvious right now that the door is open. Underhill and Martini going along so beautifully and so smoothly. And then all of a sudden, well, disaster in the sense that this is... We're 29% of the overall score.
But they have done that 9 million times. It was the entrance. It was the entrance to a, you know, to a simple move for them. How did that happen?
Yeah. How does that happen to skaters?
Well, let's wait and take a look at the slow motion and see how that entrance, what happened on that entrance. I just can't believe it. Look at her now. She's stepping back right there. And at this point, she's stepping in on that edge. Oh, I see. She got over. Look, right there. You can see it. She got over too far on that edge, and it hit the side of her boot, and the pressure came off the blade, and, of course, she lost it.
And then he goes down as well, and well, that tells the story right there.
Yeah, okay. Okay, Paul.
Barbara Underhill and Paul Martini. Awaiting their scores, but not really anticipating.
anything in light of what has just transpired. Anything good. 18-year-old Barbara Underhill from Oshawa, Ontario.
When I can go.
Paul Martini is from Woodbridge, Ontario. 23 years old, so this figured to be probably the most wide-open category. As we mentioned earlier, Scott Hamilton figures to be a lock for them. And here come the scores for technical merit. And they range from 5-1 from the British judge all the way up to a 5-4, both the American judge and the Canadian judge, giving them a 5.4 for technical merit. To follow the marks upcoming for artistic impression. And the marks for artistic impression are not bad. Again, the British judge with a 5.4. And then the U.S., Canadian, and Soviet judges with a 5.7. Let's go to Dick Button.
The second marks were very good.
What can I say?
What happened?
I don't know. I stepped into the fifth spin and just slid right off my edge. And I guess maybe I was leaning too much into it. I was getting a little bit excited, maybe.
It was, you got too far over. We could see it on slow motion that you got right over onto the edge of the edge of the boot. Paul, you got 70% of the program yet to come.
Well, anyway, it's only, you know, we look at it as a one half done. It's something that's great looking back on hearsay, but you always have to look ahead. And I think the long spin has always been our strongest part of the whole program, and I think we'll do a good one here.
Remember, you're not the only one that's made a mistake so far this evening, as I'm sure you know.
Yeah, we're gathering from marks that came up earlier, we realized somebody had missed something. But, you know, it's not the way you like to have these things go down. You like to have everyone skate their best and let the marks come up from there.
From here on in, upward.